And Susan, I have some questions for you. What do you think about the environment in Vietnam right now?
The environment of Vietnam is really, really bad. It's dirty, there's trash everywhere, the water is dirty, the air is really dirty, the pollution, and it just needs to be cleaned up a lot.
How does it compare to your country?
Compared to the US, Vietnam is a lot worse. The US is not perfect. They have dirty water and dirty air and trash and stuff just like Vietnam, but it's not to the same extent. And in the US, they work hard to really clean it up and pass laws so that if you throw trash out, you get penalized, you have to pay a fine. If your factory pollutes the air, your factory can be fined. So I think Vietnam needs to start moving in that direction.
So hello guys, I'm Sean and this is Mr. Young. And so we're gonna interview you today about the PSA. And our topic is pollution in Vietnam. So yeah. So the first question is, what are the major causes of the pollution in Vietnam?
Well, I think the one that most people notice is that just people throwing trash and garbage around. I think that's one of the more common ones. But I think what a lot of people don't realize is that factories and industries cause a lot more pollution than we think, whether it's smoke and chemicals into the air or into the land or the water. I think that's more harmful than the actual garbage and pollution.
So the second question is, what are some solutions that could actually like help and like kind of get rid of the pollution?
As for like actual garbage, I think the biggest thing is not to, I mean, yeah, it's important to go out and pick it up and stuff, but I think the best way is to educate people, to teach people that don't throw your garbage out, okay? And as for like the chemical and the industrial waste, I think a better solution to that would be for the government to be a little bit stricter and to check these factories and make sure that they're not releasing as much out into the public as what they are. Yeah, whether it's smoke, not allowing them to release as much smoke into the air, or not allowing them to release as much chemicals out into the waters, things like that. The government needs to be the one to shut that down and stop that.
Thank you, Mr. Young.
You're welcome.
For the answering our questions, and that's all the questions we have for this topic.
Okay.
Mr. Ben, I have some questions for you. So how do you think the pollution of Vietnam right now will affect our world in the future?
Good question. Probably similar to the effect that it has on the rest of the world. What we do now is really important, because if we don't make any changes to the water, any changes to the air, any changes to the traffic or transportation or the way we recycle, then the planet will continue to get warmer, get dirtier, and we'll have trouble with things like breathing,
what about sunrise?
Our bodies.
What about rain?
We have to make changes in Vietnam.
What
and
about
all
the things that you said we were
to
gain?
We do not want to have a terrible planet in the future.
What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we've shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shore? Time. What about all the dreams that you said was yours?